will be tackled today will be beneficial for the upcoming AMS qualifying examination. Forgive us our sins and keep us in your embrace. This we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you. Blessed afternoon, everyone. I am Police Silegio. I'm the deputy or assistant chief of the United Nations Peace for Camp Krame National Headquarters. And we'd like to welcome you to today's orientation for the pre-AMS, the Assistance for Mission Service. It's a three-day event that will begin on the 23rd of this month, next Wednesday, no? This coming Wednesday. And currently, there's 495 of you who are joined in, but we'll be expecting more. Actually, we received 700 plus who turned in their applications in the past 2 weeks. We thought it would be beneficial to all to communicate with you through this platform the necessary preparation and the other details you need to be informed about for this activity. So I'll be turning you over to our action officer at UNPOC, si PEMS Arin, who will be going over the policies, the activities for the three-day event, and then we'll lead to question and answer. And then some more announcements so you can better prepare for next week's major activity. It's a major activity because this has been approved by Chief PNP, and we've coordinated with lateral offices all the necessary preparation for the venues and other logistical requirements. On our part, we are prepared to accommodate you on Wednesday, and we hope that this orientation will also prepare you, as this will be a very good opportunity one. So we'll see you around. I'll turn you over to PEMS Arim for our orientation prop.
Yes, good afternoon, sir, ma'am. Sino po ba yung lahat po ba na is nakapag na-receive nila yung initial na policy na binigay namin? Thumbs up po. Sinare po namin siya doon sa ano, sa R9. Okay po, salamat. So medyo ano lang kasi hindi ko pa na-explore tong pag-share ng ano nung para mai latag natin to sa anong sa screen regarding dun sa ano natin. So meron na po kayong ano, meron na po ba kayong nakuha ang digital copy, correct?
Tayo wala.
So dito lang po, simple lang naman yung policies and guideline natin na i-share, ipapa-implement sa PRISA at examiners po natin. Sa opening day po is ang reporting time natin sa Camp Karame is 5 a.m. Tapos ang registration time natin is 5:30 to 7 in the morning. So, sorry po sa mga magiging latecomers, hindi na po natin i-entertain. Tapos ang uniform of the day sa first day is standard po kasi sa Karame ma'am sa NHQ is Goa A for PNC for PCO and Goa B for PNCO. So hindi na po tayo sa mga PNCO po is hindi na po tayo mag read sa opening. Take note po, opening tong pinag-uusapan natin ha. Opening ceremonies, ang magiging venue po is yung PNP Transformation Oval or the PNP Grandstand. So again, uulitin ko po is opening day is on August 23, reporting time is 5 a.m. So 5:30 to 7 is registration time. Goa A for PCO, Goa B for PNCO without duty rig. Tapos sa ganun pa rin, registry sa 20 on the 24th sa second day natin. So sa driving driving test na natin may I ask po sir ma'am, majority po ba ng participants meron ng PNP patrol shirt? Thumbs up po. Majority po ba?
Wala po sir.
Wala po sir.
Negative sir.
Wala po sir. Sige po.
We will
consider that Goa C. Kung wala pong hindi po available ang PNP patrol uniform po C. Same with sa firing po. Sa marksmanship training kasi natin so lahat naman po tayo nakapag-undergo na nung handgun classification, correct?
Yes sir.
Handgun classification. So yes, sir. Ang standard naman po natin is standard ang ginagamit dito is Goa C kung in the absence of the FSU sa mga mobile units kasi sa mga majumbaring company sa mga regions usually naman inaallow pero para to ease out your burden lalo na po yung mga galing natin sa mga far flung regions po either Goa C. Goa C or patrol uniform will do. Tapos ang isa pa po nating isa pa nating concern is again we will reiterate from you all over again na please come on time on the venue area kasi yun pwede po maging grounds for disqualification yon. So kung meron pong nakakuha na nung electronic copy, i-reiterate ko lang po uli. Do exactly as you are told. Violations will be grounds for that disqualifications or DQ. So sa overall, sa setup po natin sa Camp Karame, ang reminder lang po namin na ipapaano sa inyo, lalo na po yung hindi NHQ-based na mga PRISA at examinees. So to avoid caution in issuance of DR, kasi po sa NHQ po is nag-i-issue po talaga sila ng so observe, avoid littering and loitering. So with regards to i-designate po na loading area. So basic naman po, littering inside the car is strictly prohibited. Observe tamang bihis at all times. When I say tamang bihis, pagdating ito include po ha, ito include yung headgear, wearing of headgear. Saka every time po na aalis or papayagan is magpaalam po lagi sa mga marshals or sa from DPL personnel, whether it is PCO, PNCO or NUP po, basta po yung involved at saka in charge po dun sa activity na to. So ang isa rin pong dinidiscourage namin ay yung pagdala po ng personal na sasakyan. Bakit po? Hindi naman sa ayaw namin kayong magpumasok na may sasakyan. Ang ano po kasi dito, ang isa pang avoid looking from side to side. So very basic naman po yan pag nag-exam. Glancing may be cause for DQ sa first stage pa lang. That is, ito po yung reading and report writing test. So once po glancing is observed, nakita po kayo ng proctor, so pasensya na po sir ma'am. Ng proctor na nakahuli sa inyo, then you will be escorted out to the multipurpose hall. So, connivance in any other form, sharing of answer. Tapos, ang magiging consequence pa nun, pwede pa po tayong ma-pre-charge. Only when permitted. Proctor wala pong magsisisigaw na oh mali trabaho yung the usual po pag nasa open space. para pag tayo. Kasi isa at with regards to your question. Thank you, sir, ma'am, and good afternoon.
Salamat, Pems Arin. Sige, we'll start quickly with the Q&A. Pwede niyong i-type sa chat box and we'll try to answer them one by one. So we'll do that. Now we'll give everyone in the chat box and we'll go over them one. So much accounts that we've opened and logged in. And we don't want to take much of your weekend time with family. Between today until Tuesday next week, because Monday is a holiday, through your PRO. And strategy offices at other units. So do key in your questions in the chat box and we'll try to read them one by one in 2 minutes.
Sir, ma'am, may nagtanong po doon sa chat box. Female po, yata, presumably, pwede po na, na Goa pants na lang po. Goa pants para, para at ease yung galaw. Tapos yung regarding po sa firing issued firearms, automatic yan. Issued firearms po ang ang dadalhin niyo po.
Okay.
May naka-raise hand si Sir Police Lieutenant Colonel Guerrero, if I may, go ahead, sir.
Hello, sir. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yung nabanggit niyo, very about dun sa first day na mangyayari. Para ang narinig ko lang ay ano dun, opening. So after the opening, mga 8 o'clock, ganun, start na yung exam, ganun ba?
With regards to that matter, sir, we're going to have an opening ceremony. So on cue naman, sir, kung sino po yung mag-start na, kung anong oras, what time, basta every ano, sir, every galaw po ng mga examinees is on cue naman po sa amin, sa mga DPL staff, kung ano po yung magiging next move. Ang pinaprevent po kasi natin dito rin is, yes sir, go ahead, sir.
I'll try to answer that para first day, no? So you'll be required to be here as early as 5 a.m. That's the time they're going to open the registration. And then by 7 a.m. Minaka-open na mic. By 7 a.m. until 7:30, depende kung yung mga humahabol ay ma-allow na maka-register and we filled up all the ang target kasi natin is 743, I think. Kung may madagdag man dyan, malalaman natin sa D-Day mismo. If everyone is in, 8 a.m. is the scheduled opening ceremony at the grandstand din. So you'll all be instructed to form yourselves in front of the grandstand on a fair day. If the weather does not... So that's no less than the officer in charge of Directorate for Plans. As soon as he's done with his message and the appropriate pleasantries and photo ops, you'll be broken down into groups, 2 batches actually. You'll take time to go to the next venue, which is the multi-purpose hall for the first stage, which is the language competency assessment. By batch yan, dahil you're a big group, we believe 2 batches is enough for everyone. So as soon as we're done with the 2 batches, whoever passes the first stage will move on to the computer literacy stage the same day, Wednesday. And then you come back the next day, that's August 24, for the driving test. And that's in 2 parts. Yung handling and the road exercise. The handling exercise will require you to specifics with an SUV. Pina-finalize pa namin exactly kung anong SUV yan, but we're required to make you undergo these tests using an SUV as much as possible, a 4x4, kasi yan ang actual na vehicle ginagamit sa mission areas. But whatever will be provided, you'll be required to perform with it. Okay? Yun ang gagamitin ninyo. For all activities, rain or shine, we will proceed with the stages. So that's Thursday, August 24. Two parts of the driving exercise allotted for the whole day of August 24. You'll come back on the last day, August 25, that's a Friday, for your firing exercise or assessment. Also, two parts for the handling, assembly, disassembly, and the last part, which is the firing assessment. After everyone is done, we'll require you to come back to the multipurpose hall for the closing ceremony. So that more or less describes how the process will move from the first stage to the last stage. As to the specific details, you'll all be instructed to specifically follow the as you are there on site, as you come after you've been processed a registration. So I hope that's clear with everyone. Unless you have other questions, sino yung nagtanong kanina? Si Colonel Guerrero?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes. Sir,
another question, sir. Sir, yung ito, so no need na po to bring yung mga documentary requirements, I think, kasi hindi naman nabanggit.
Hindi, ito, babanggitin natin. Hindi mo ba nabanggit, Sergeant Arim?
Hindi pa, sir. Yun yung
anyway, sige, babanggitin ko ngayon. Para yes, for everyone's information, and this is very important, you need to bring with you original documents for, one, PNP ID, to you are who you are, original and updated PNP ID, two, your PAIS-generated PDS, personal data sheet, okay, PAIS generated PDS. So we would know if your rank is exactly who you are, what it is, no? Kasi minsan, if you just been promoted, hindi agad na update ang ID. And it will take some time before you are issued an ID. Minsan nga, you would reissued an updated ID. Then third, a valid driver's license. Ulitin ko, for these three, we need you to show us your original PNP ID to tell us who you are, that you are who you are. Second, the PAIS generated PDS. So your rank tells us that updated ka sa rango mo if you've just recently been promoted. And that, in fact, you qualify for the requirement, the rank requirement for the pre-SAAT or pre-AMS exam. And did I mention the PAIS or the PNP-generated PDS? Original yon.
Yes, sir.
Now, we will not be keeping them. We will be validating them with the Xerox copies of those documents. We'll be returning the original documents with you. But you'll be giving to us the copies of those documents para hindi mawala sa amin. Ibabalik namin sa inyo. But we need to validate the original documents. Okay? Addition to that, we also need to see the recommendations from your respective units, yung unit recommendation. Now, there's a question to this we've been getting since yesterday. In fact, the whole week, this whole week, kung anong level ng unit recommendation ang iaallow. As far as the Chief Unpok has already agreed, if you are in the regional offices, the PD level unit endorsement would suffice your being allowed to join this exercise. Kaya lang, some PROs, may policy CRD requiring everyone to have your applications reach his office for his approval. Hindi naman namin pwedeng restrict ang policy ni RD. And he has his valid reasons. And for that, you have no option but to follow RD's policy. Kailangan nyo mag-submit ng application on all the way to the regional level. If you have from your respective units, kung sa police station ka, na-forward PPO, and then PPO dapat ang mag-forward sa region through the respective R9s. Kailangan nyo hintayin yung official communication ni RD. But we understand that may take some time, lalo na yung ibang clearances na we shall be going into. But before we leave the issue of the unit endorsement, this is very important. Along with the original documents na I mentioned kanina, you'll be giving us the original copy of the unit endorsement. Is for DPL. Okay. Ang ibibalik namin sa inyo yung copy niyan. Ang kailangan din namin yung original niyan. Okay? So, importante yon ha, yung apat na yon. And then going to the clearances.
Verify may
sir. It's standard policy for...
Yes? Verify may sa endorsement sir. Kasi may some endorsement sir ay maraming nakalagay na pangalan. So, isa lang po ang may hawak ng original copy.
That's fine. Fine. Walang problema ron. We will take note of that. So long as each one in the unit endorsement has a copy of that, and then someone has to inform us na yung original is with someone. And then we will know doon na sa on-site, sa registration. Madali na yun. Okay? Okay ba, Colonel Guerrero? Did I answer your question?
Sir.
We will just inform our assessors. If the unit endorsement come in groups, everyone has to have a copy of that, obviously. But we need an original copy of that. Someone has that, for sure. Diba? Hindi pa pwedeng puro Xerox yan. Kasi the original unit endorsement is purposefully for the office sa amin, sa DPL. That shouldn't be hard to do. Kasi hindi naman pwedeng Xerox lang ang ibibigay nyo sa amin. We need the original copy. If you are in a group, someone from the group has to give us that original copy. As early as now, you should have that. You should know who has that copy. Hindi pwedeng copy ng unit endorsement lang ang ibibigay nyo sa amin. And it's good that you raise it up para maklaro natin as early as now. Okay? Any more question, Colonel Guerrero?
Another thing, sir, yung ano, regarding doon sa ammunition during the fire.
Can I just finish muna yung clearances?
Sige, sir. Opo.
Sige. Okay. Sige, sir. Balikan kita ha, yung sa ammunition. Tapusin ko lang tong documents kasi... Ang NBI and the National Police Clearance of the same category and or na lang yan. Whether you applied and got a clear certificate from NBI or DLOD, Ombudsman, and CHR, lalo na ang Ombudsman that takes some time. So, I understand yung duration niyan might exceed given the conduct of this exam. What we need to see with you when you come on Wednesday is proof of application in form of stamps, in form of receipt copies. You did actually apply. Okay? You need to show us those proof of application. Pag wala, conditional ang inyong participation sa previous assessment. Okay, depende sa KF Unpok kung iaalaw kayong mag-join o hindi. E klaro yan sa requirements natin, the clearances. You need to show your proof of application for three. Okay. Kailangan nyo mapakita yan. Hindi pwedeng unit endorse lang. You need to have proof of application for the clearance. We understand na matagal i-release yan, lalo na yung ombudsman, para to show us the stub or the receipt copy. Klaro tayo dyan. Self-explanatory. Okay? I'm done with documents. Dun pa lang kayo sa baba ng grandstand, parang Jollibee, merong advance order taker who will validate you have the documents. Pag laking yan, hindi na kayo makakaakyat. Okay? Pag laking yan, hindi na kayo papakyatin sa registration. Make sure as early as now, you have those documents with you. Especially, once, di nito accept the unit endorsement. For a group, ulitin ko ulit for the last time, for a group in the unit endorsement, we need the original copy of that. Isa lang sa grupo. And a copy for everyone else that you'd have to keep with you. Klaro po tayo doon. Any question before we move on to the next? Okay, balikan ko yung question ni Colonel Guerrero. What is it exactly about ammunition?
Regarding ammunition,
pakilakas.
Ammunition, sir.
Oh, ulit.
Sir, ratio din ng DPL yung ammunition during the fire.
Yes. In the firing exercise, if you be fortunate enough to reach the third stage, there are two parts, actually three. First is the handling part. Second is the 5-meter distance firing exercise. Will be required to fire 5 rounds. And the last part is the 7-meter firing exercise. Will you be required to fire 5 rounds. So 10 rounds yan. Wala kayong dadaling ammunition. It will be provided for everyone. Okay? But you are required to bring your own firearm. It's ideal to use your firearm, your own fire-issued firearm for this part. Before we meet. Question, nasagot ko na to. Sir, good PM po, wala po bang i-provide na firearms during sa test? Wala. Because you're expected to fire your own issued firearm. But we've requested with TS to provide the firearms that would be ready for the handling, yung assembly, disassembly. But for the firing test, it only makes sense na you use your own firearm. Pag nanghiram ka, edi isi-zero mo pa yon. We will not allow you extra time for that. As soon as you join the fourth stage, which is the firing exercise, you're expected to be ready to be tested on the firing exercise with your own firearm. Klaro tayo dyan, ha? Klaro tayo dyan. Next question. For the firing stage po, issued firearm po ba ang and how many amos? Nasagot na natin. Wala kayong dadaling bala. It will be provided. May height requirements po ba para sa UN mission po? Wala. Kung you are an official member of the PNP, the assumption is you're qualified to join or at least participate in this pre-AMS evaluation program, provided you've satisfied also the criteria. 2 years left in the service. Among other things, walang height requirement doon. Okay? Given na yan sa being a member of the PNP. In case po sa firing, kami po ba magpo-provide ng bala? Nasagot na. Good afternoon, sir. I'll just finish these questions and we'll go over your other questions online, ha? Need po ba kumpletuhin ang laman ng rig? No. Hindi kailangan may posas, hindi naman yan kasama sa assessment, baton, and tickler. Okay? When you're patrolling, you should be fully equipped with the rig. Pero for this exercise, para maka-perform kayo ng maayos and comfortably, we allow you not to bring your not to wear your rig during this part. Paki-off ang mic, please. Sarili po bang expense ang bala? Nasagot na.
Di kasi nagkuha daan silang question sa chat box ba? So, yan man yung dati nila. Kaya pare-pareha ang question.
Yes, ma'am.
Tapos nawala.
Oo.
Question yung gosh.
Master Sergeant Serrano, kindly.
Binabasa ko lang please. Po yung ano. Binabasa ko lang yung questions for everyone's information before we go to your online questions. Naka-pre-AMS po ako last 2018. Ano po status noon? This is a personal question. You ask this in the duty phone. Wala tayong listahan ng mga 2018. Pems Ricote from Leyte PPO. Get in touch with us through the UNPOC duty phone. Okay, hindi to related sa activities sa Wednesday. Sir, good afternoon. Sa second day, clarify ko lang kung nag-duty rig po ba. Nasagot na to. Walang duty rig sa driving. Ang amo sa inyo ba? Sa amin po ba? Hindi. We will provide for the ammunition bukod sa mga protector. The safety equipment are yours. Bring your own safety equipment. Your e-reader and your eye. Nasagot na yung holster. What is the estimated time sa matapos ang each stage? I don't think this is a related question. Why? If it takes you the whole day, why do you want to know? Okay? Depende yan sa dami ninyo at sa mag-move sa next stage. I don't know why you need to know that. Kung may lakad ka ba after? Paki-message ako personal para I will answer this question personally also. Are we allowed to leave after each stage? No. You'll be required to come back to the staging area. You have to understand, the reason why we ask for your unit endorsement, you will be under our detail for the duration of this 3-day assessment. Okay? So you'll be do exactly as you're told to stay at the staging area. Issued clearance. The Bangsamoro Human Rights Commission had official trip which caused the delay of my clearance dahil wala pong signatory. Pwede po ba ang scanned document, sir? Probably Tuesday pa mapipirmahan ang clearance. Can you show us a proof that you applied? And then the validator will assess. Okay, for so long as you have the original documents and you show us that you have applied for this specific clearance, chances are you'll be allowed to join. Pwede po bang manghiram ng ibang examinee sa ibang examinees in case na hindi makadala ng issued firearms? Yes, you may borrow your At tapusin ko lang ha, mga lima pa atang questions to. Pwede ba manghiram ng barel? Nasagot na. Sa ilang UN mission po ba meron ngayon na involve ang PNP? Mga trivia question na lang ito. Sa ngayon, isa. United Nations mission in South Sudan. The chances are before the year is over, three more will open. The chances of that happening, we'll pray for it. Ibig sabihin, pag pumasa kayo dito, baka kayo ang susunod na i-deploy doon. But for us to know exactly, we don't have that, we're not privy. It's all upon the decision and the of the management of United Nations headquarters in New York. Kailan ang saat pag pumasa dito sa pre-AMS? At the rate of how the last pre-AMS in 2018 and the previous one in 2017, ang last is 2018. So can you just imagine, today is 2023. Depende yan sa needs ng mga mission areas. 10 years ago, taon-taon may deployment, but fast forward now, 2020, 2023, naging matumal for reasons beyond our control. So hindi natin masagot to, no? Objectively.
Sir, may I ask for last question?
Go ahead.
Sir, regarding dun sa last date ng schedule, sir, I think it was declared holiday, sir.
August 25?
Yes, sir.
What's your question?
Sir, I mean, tuloy yung schedule natin, sir, regardless kung holiday, sir, sa declaration.
Official command activity ito. We're not affected by holidays.
That's all, sir.
Unless we want to forgo, wag naman sana, tapusin na natin to. Exciting naman yung 13 nyo.
Directive, sir.
Okay. Okay ba yun? Yung sagot natin, we will proceed holiday or non-working or declared siya, we will proceed with the schedule. Pag na-fail po sa first stage, tama po ba? Hindi na magpo-proceed sa second stage? Yes, that's what knock-off or knock-out system is about. You need to pass the first stage to be able to move to the next one. Good PM po, taga Mindanao, pwede po bang hindi magdala ng firearms, manghiram na lang kami? Pwede. Okay? Pwede kayong hindi magdala ng firearms, pwede kayong manghiram. Contrary to our recommendation to use your own. Okay? For obvious reason. You wanna do well shooting, gagamitin nyo yung baril na kabisado nyo. But it's entirely up to you. You may use someone else's firearm kung mahirap magdala. Good afternoon po, sir. If ever may ibang tasking, FIBA World Cup, hindi po ba makakapunta ng exam? Magkakaroon po ba ang administrative sanction? Kung nabigyan ka, kung kasama ka sa LO, that's enough reason for you to join and exempt you from official duties during this time. Taga NCR siguro to. I hope I answered your question, okay? Kung engaged ka ng preparation sa FIBA World Cup, this is August 25, but included ka naman sa LO, the LO precedes, supersede your official function in the FIBA World Cup. At dapat ma-honor yan sa unit mo. Alright? Okay. Kasi this is an official command activity approved by no less than the Chief PNP. Signal, we understand that. Okay lang. And i-disseminate na lang itong ating announcement and guidance sa mga kasama. Driver's license po ang keep the copy, but we just need both to validate yes. Ulitin ko ha, will the endorsement from the PD suffice? Yes. But if your RD requires you to apply the request for unit endorsement through his office, siya po ang masusunod. Depende po to ha, regional peculiarity ito. On our part, the PD endorsement is enough if RD is okay with it, na walang issue sa kanya na hindi dumaan yung application. But for some regions, naghigpit si RD, kinommunicate ni R9, lahat ng applications, kailangan muna ng signature ni RD. RD prevail. Alright? Pero kung nakasama ka sa LO, maski na wala pang lumalabas na post office, ang LO po ay galing ng DP. Okay? So, that more or less gives you a sense of authority higher than the level of RD. So, if you're saying na nasa LO ka pero hindi pumayag si RD, I would not understand na you will suffer administrative complaint or report sa unit mo. Eh, mukhang kailangan mong i-clear yan kay R9. Before you leave, nasa LO po ako na pinablish ng DP. Pero you're requiring us to wait for RD's go signal. Diba? Sino bang masusunod na office? They should be able to answer it, I think. I'm sure. Okay po? Okay, I'm done with the chat box questions. Are there any questions we'd like to answer before we end our time this afternoon? Any more questions, sir, Paul?
Good evening po, sir. Same as si Bart po, sir. May be recognized, sir.
Go ahead.
Sir, tanong ko lang, sir, sa first day, ano ba yung i-require na dalhin namin? Bullpen, pencil, paper, whatever. Ano bang dapat namin dalhin dun sa first day, sir?
Okay, good question. So first day, you're all required to bring, because that's also the examination for the reading comprehension and the report writing, you're all required to bring blue ball pen.
Sir, kung inaudible po yung ano yung question sa alam, pwede niyo naman pong i-type sa chat box, sir, ma'am, para po mas maganda.
Okay, may humabol na question. Sa clearances, pag wala po mga clearances at nag-attend kami, hindi naman po kami ma-precharge. Pag wala kayong clearances, hindi kayo i-allow mag-join. Because that's part of the requirement. I hope we're clear on this, ha? Pag wala kayong clearances or any proof that you applied for it, hindi kayo ia-allow mag-join. You should at least application for your clearances. If you cannot show any proof, you will not be allowed to join. Okay? Anything more?
Sir, Sergeant Ortiz from Pro 8, sir.
Go ahead.
Dilos clearance namin, sir. Okay lang po ba, sir, kung dilos po na clearance lang muna yung dala namin, sir?
Ang dilos, actually, ang magpo-forward ng request ng application nyo to dilod. Dilod ang required eh. Pero if you can show us you've already applied at the dilos level, that will do. Pero dapat conditional ka, bale, hanggat hindi mo pinapasa ang D-load clearance, because that's specific in the requirements, D-load. Pero D-loss is the initial acceptance of the request. Doon yung ipapasa, di ba? Tapos D-loss ang mag-endorse sa D-load. And that takes time. Kaya nga we allow you to at least show us. Go ahead.
Sir, kasi yung endorsement po.
Yeah, how do you know you were endorsed by your unit?
Si director po mismo nag-send sir sa ano namin, classmate namin sir. And then after that sir, hindi na po namin alam kung sino na may hawak sir.
Pa-check niyo na lang sa secretariat kung sino naka-receive ng regional copy. Doon dito lang naman nata kayo sa Krame, di ba?
Hindi po sir, sa region po kami sir, sa Zamboanga City po.
You still have time. Can you just please check that? Para sayang naman kung pumayag si unit commander nyo tapos hindi nyo mapakita yung original, all you can show is sa copy. How can we validate?
Hindi po ba pwede support namin yun?
Namin sa part namin, then we will allow you to take the exam. Kaya lang you need to travel na, no? As early as Monday or Tuesday?
Actually, sir, we have our flight tomorrow. May allowance po kami isang araw, sir, kasi yung first day, sir, is holiday. Kaya ina-expect po namin walang tao dun, sir.
Pero pinayagan kayo ni regional chief nyo, for sure.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
O sige, go. Nasa sa inyo naman yun eh. Ang the worst thing can happen pagbalik nyo, pre-charge kayo, ha? So, that's
it. Pwede pong i-screenshot na lang po na kami yung pag-send ni director in case pwede namin matrace yung ano, sir.
Sige, sige. Yung sige, sige,
sino
sige,
may hawak, sige. Sir. Thank you po.
Yes, yes. Okay, okay.
Sir,
anything more?
Sir, ma'am,
go ahead, go ahead po. Go ahead po. Go ahead po.
Sir, tanong ko lang si Master Terania kung may nag-reply ba sa iyo sa inbox ng Unpok. Master, nag-request acknowledgement na ba yung, kasi kung nagpadala kayo doon sa inbox ng official email namin, matatanggap namin yon. Ang tanong ko po ba doon is meron po bang nag-reply acknowledge sa inyo? At when most probably when did you communicate that ano that endorsement to UNPO?
Yes sir, na acknowledge na po kami, pero po kami po kasi kami po directly talaga ang nag-send sa inyo sir.
Your unit endorsement. Saka kung anong
yes, level, sir.
Kung kay Director HPG ba or kay Regional Commander nyo lang po ng HPG, Region 9?
Kay Director po. Kay Director po
okay,
na
kay
ano,
Director.
Signed, sir. Kasi kami po mismo na, ang nagpadala, ano po, sir.
Opo, yung ano na mismong digital copy na po nung ano niyo, nung director's recommendation niyo na po, hindi na si regional commander. Correct?
Okay po. Yes, sir.
Correct po ba 'yon, yung presumption ko na nagpadala na kayo ng unit endorsement na si duly signed by Director HPG?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Sige po. Okay.
Sige, yes, everyone. We will answer your queries. No, I think we've answered the really important ones, but the more significant yung ating orientation during the first hour. Yung house to hindi nyo na
ang sabi po kasi nung chief clerk ng S9 namin dito sa Pampanga, ang sagot niya, hindi na daw magpapapirma ang R9 kay RD kung gusto nyo kayo na sir ang lumakad para magpapirma kay RD na personal, which is I think parang baka naman po hindi tama. So ang finorward ko na lang po sa UN POC is the copy that I have na inacknowledge naman po ng UN POC through their reply email, sir.
So technically po, yung unit level na nag-endorse sa'yo, anong unit po?
Is the provincial director, sir.
That's fine. That is fine. May yes, original sir. Copy kayo nun?
I do not have the original, sir.
Oh, asan yung original nun? Wala, na kay R9.
Yun nga po, sir, yung i-finorward kay R9, sir.
Ay, malapit ka lang naman, ano, PRO3?
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
I think you still have time to at least secure the original copy with R9 kasi that's very important to us. Para sa amin yung, ano eh, sa amin naka-address yung unit endorsement eh.
Sir, will it be an option kung hingi kami ng endorsement from PD na lang? Instead of...
Yes. Oo.
Ah, okay, sir.
Yes. Oo. Sir, kailangan namin yung original copy. You have to understand, mga kasama, no? Kasi sa technology ngayon, madaling mag-scan, madaling mag-modify ng documents.
Yes, sir.
That's why we need to have original copies. The original copy should be addressed to us, DPL, saying you were in... require you to go through him first at hindi kayo dumaan, you will suffer that ano that policy sa level niya pagbalik nyo. You understand?
Yes, sir. But so far, sir, wala naman po kaming narinig na ganung instructions from RD, sir.
Okay. Sige. Kasi hindi na namin babalikan si RD. Hindi na namin iko-communicate si RD to allow you specifically. Kasi yes, general sir. Naman yung aming coordination. Okay? I hope everyone understands that.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Anything else po? Because we need to wrap up.
Yes, sir. Isang tanong lang po, sir.
Wait po. Go ahead po.
PCMS Sibar, sir, from IAS. Ang tanong ko lang, sir, is yung unit endorsement ko kasi, sir, is electronic document from the Inspector General mismo. And would it suffice na, sir, na electronic documents lang yung binigay sa amin or kailangan naman talaga namin magpapirma doon sa NIAS talaga, sir?
Ideally, as I already mentioned, we need to see and have that copy, the original document. But kayo po, kung sa tingin nyo, you can vouch for the validity of the document for so long as we will indeed find out na it is valid. I think we will allow you. But kung hindi nyo mapakita sa amin yung conditional kayo, hindi nyo mapakita sa amin yung original yan, conditional kayo.
And one thing also, sir, yung ano, sir, ba, yung deload, no? Kasi yung nung mag-query ako dun sa NIAS regarding sa deload namin, sabi nila may sarili kaming deload. So may issue sila na clearance pero nakalagay dun delos. So ano ba yung status ng delos ng IAS or may delos talaga na hihingi kami ng ano, sir, clearance ng delos sa national? Kasi nasa IAS ako, sir.
Sa IAS po, alam ko, pwede kayo ng delos sa IAS.
Ah, pwede na, sir.
Opo, opo.
Ah, okay, sir. Thank you. Yun lang po, sir. Salamat.
Please send your queries and other questions sa duty phone ng UNPOC, DPL. Well, we need to wrap up. We've already taken 3 hours of your time this afternoon as we also need to come back to our tasks in preparation for next week. So, eto, may mga mahabol na questions. Pakibato na lang sa UNPOC duty phone, okay? Dahil we also need to attend to other the rest of our day today. It's a weekend and we hope everyone will also enjoy the rest of your weekend with your families. Kung naka-duty kayo, rest well and prepare well for next week's activity. Yung mga mahabol pang questions, we'll just answer your questions sa duty phone and sa email natin.
Sir, and then post po ng phone number, sir.
Sorry?
Sir, ano yung po, please pakipost po ng duty phone ng phone box, sir.
Alright. I think everyone is nakalag naman ata lahat ng nasa 700 na yung nakalag sa duty phone ng UNPOC eh. I don't know why you need to have that posted. But sino ba to? Paka-take note nga to, ano? I'm sorry, si Pro 10. Pakisama na lang dun sa contact list ng duty phone. Si Pem Cyril, what's your last name?
Postrero po, sir.
Postrero. Masama siya rin sa duty phone. And everyone else who need
sir,
to join.
Sir, po, I already posted our number dito sa chat box. Kindly take note na lang mga sir, ma'am.
Okay, so that's all we can discuss with you today. And we've held you for more than 2 hours na. Limited din yung ating account dahil you're such a big group. We would like to thank you for joining us. And this is the first time we've actually done an orientation prior to the conduct, before the conduct of any AMS or UNSAS or UNSAAT exercise. So, salamat for allowing us that opportunity. As we think, the guidance and the policies need to be clear with everyone. And we don't lose time for additional instructions, no? Sa actual conduct, we could get on the exercise immediately. So, we pray that everyone will be blessed with this opportunity. Safe travels, everyone, and God bless all. Salamat po. Mag-ingat po ang lahat.
Thank you po, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Maraming salamat, sir.
Thank you, sir. God bless.
Thank you, sir. God bless.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
God bless po.
Thank you, sir. God bless.